If you're the curious sort like me, you look out into that infinite universe and wonder what's out there. It's humbling to think about how big the universe is and how small in comparison the Earth is. I've loved science for as long as I can remember. I became a doctor and learned a lot about science, but it's my curiosity about the great what if that called me to be a writer of suspense. I merged my two worlds, and now I spend my time researching science and history so I can write about those things that could, in some space and time, happen, even if it hasn't happened yet. Welcome to my universe, where I like to know it all, and I like to know it now. According to Mayan prophecy, the world will end this year. Now, maybe that won't happen, but if you're a logical person, you realize everything eventually ends. Most of us try not to think about it too much. But while I do research for my novels, it's my job to think up terrible situations that seem fatal or unexplainable. So I actually think of potential disasters nearly every day. For the next few weeks, we're going to look at some of the ways the world could come to an end. Conspiracy theorists, grab your notebooks. You're going to love this.
The odds of a black hole consuming the Earth would seem to be extraordinarily small. They must exist in the galaxy. They must be out there because stars do explode and leave behind these remnants. The odds of one coming close enough to the Earth, though, would seem to be minuscule. The solar system's been stable now for 4,500,000,000 years. If the Earth and the solar system are stable for 4,500,000,000 years of history, if it were going to happen, it likely would have already happened.
Did you know many amateur stargazers make significant contributions to the field of astronomy? They monitor stars, they track asteroids, they even make their own discoveries. Stop by Facebook and tell me, if this were your last day on Earth, what would you do? I'll be reading your posts and commenting myself. Until next week, stay curious.